Hello, Mr. Nygren here. So this is Total War 1942 version 2.0. It's the real 2.0 version that Dagvex Rianus, the creator of the mod, released 2 days ago. He released a patch yesterday and I installed it just now, like an hour ago. Okay, so this mod is for Rome Total War and Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. It's not for Rome Total War Alexander. Okay, and it works for both the CD, the pirated version, and the Steam version. So the pirated version is the CD version, so that's the same version as the CD. And then we have the the Steam version. It works on both, and with the patch, finally we can play on the CD version without an annoying issue every time we start a battle. You had to tab out and exit an error message and such. I believe certain files were not packed I believe they came packed in the CD version and they were unpacked in the Steam version, so there were some differences there. Okay, another difference is that in the Steam version the battlefields are more beautiful and the graphics are more enhanced, which means you have more lag if you play with the huge settings, the huge size. For example, I played 3 armies versus 3 armies on the battlefield of Normandy, and in the CD version it won't lag on my computer, but when I play the same battle with the same armies on the Steam version it actually lagged, because the battlefields were more beautiful there. That's why I prefer playing with the CD version, because I have less lag. Okay. So we can take a look at the custom battles. So now we can see that Dagvex, we can add arcade style battles can be checked there, but otherwise we have difficulty settings and game types, only siege assaults available here. Okay, show advanced conditions here we can do different options like weather, season, time of day, time limit, settlement defense, settlement culture, huge city, etc., advice level. So we can see that we have some sea battles, like before, for the ships, custom battle. Then we have some battlefields for custom battles on land. I played on the Normandy battlefield. I recorded that battle too. We will upload it as well, but I will probably upload this first, even though I played the Normandy battle before I did this recording. But I prefer this recording to be kind of a preview. Okay, then we have some others. We have the battlefields are the Great Lakes, the Ardennes, which is the forest outside of France. I don't know where the Great Lakes are, but I use it as the Russian front. Okay, Karelia, that's Finland. Okinawa, that's close to Japan. It was held by Japan, and the Americans were fighting the Japanese there. But it's not in Japan, it's an ire outside of Japan, held by Japan. Okay, then we have the Solomon Islands. And I believe I actually don't know where they are located. Sahara Desert, that's in Africa. Rommel's campaign against the British and the French, and later the United States. Sicily, that's of course Italy. The campaign against Italy by the Allies. Operation, whatever it was named, I don't remember. Wake Iceland, Ireland. Then we have some custom settlements. We have Cain. It is one of the settlements I had in my Let's Play. I was about to say that I played a campaign as the Germans in last year. I played during the entire year. I started the campaign in January 2020 and I ended it on December 24, 2020. I lost the campaign as the Germans in the main World War II campaign. And that version wasn't a released version, it was the version 2.0 beta, but it was a beta from January 2020. It didn't have the new units, the new projectiles, the new smaller campaign. The most of the settlements weren't added, and lots of other stuff like religions and scripts and other stuff. But it had most of the German cities, it had German town, the German large town, the German city, and the German large city. So Berlin in that version was a large city. In this version, however, they have added more cities, so Cayenne here is one of the cities that were in the version that I played. That version was never released to the public, but I played it, I got it, and I played an entire German campaign in it. So this version is released on modub.com. It's the real 2.0 version. I don't know about stability. So in the January 2020 version that I had and played, I still have it by the way, the game could crash randomly before and after battles. So I had to save before every battle and after every battle to prevent, you know, having to replay everything. Replay battles because, you know, if you fight the battle and it's CTD after the battle, it's good to have saved before the battle so you can start before it and play it again immediately. You don't have to redo everything else that you did. And if you save after, then you won't need to replay that battle. If it worked to, you know, go back to the campaign map. Okay. So the version I played last year, it had some issues with CTD before and after battles, but you could always start it up and continue. It didn't have a regular CTD. So I tried 2.0 a few months back, but it wasn't this version of 2.0. It was an earlier version, and the main World War II campaign wasn't playable. It would CTD at a certain point every time. I believe most of the time already at turn 2 or 4 or 10 or something, but but one time I actually managed to play during the entire 1942 year, and I did the record, but then it started to CTD every time when I reached 1943 or whatever. Yeah, I think it was 1943. Okay, so I don't know about this version. It may be as unstable as that one, or it may not be. We will have to see. Then I also tried the European campaign, and it seemed stable when I just clicked end turn, but I don't know. I haven't finished a full campaign in the 2.0 version in any of the campaigns. But I'm worried that the main campaign will be unstable and won't be, you know, fully playable. There's a risk it will CTD at the same time every time you reach that turn. Every turn, I believe it might crash at one point, and then when you start it up and try to play again, it will just crash at the same location every time. That's an issue that wasn't in the version I played last year. And if that issue is in this version, then I won't be able to play an entire campaign. But if it isn't, then sure, we will play a campaign in this version too. I will try the European campaign and the main campaign. If one of them is stable, we will play the one that is stable. If both are stable, we will play both. And if none of them are stable, well, then I could try to port some stuff, units, projectiles, animations, to the other version that is stable and play it instead. But then we won't have all the cool other features, and especially not all the new custom settlements. Which is a shame if that's the case. Okay, so we have some cities here. Even London is using a German city. Munich is using a German city. This is the city, I believe, that I played in when I fought the Battle of Berlin, because Berlin wasn't finished in the January 2020 version. Here we have the German large town. Here we have a new city, Paris. Completely new. Okay, hard to see which one of these, which city they are. This is probably the city. Okay, we have Berlin with a picture. So they go back, try to be close to the real thing. So it's pretty cool. And we have Paris, as I said, but without picture. Okay, let's click on one battlefield or dense or something. And just check the factions. So we have India and the British Commonwealth of Nations selected. We can add the United States of America. French Republic. I can add the Soviet Union or the United Soviet Socialist Republic, the USSR. Add the Chinese Republic, which is today's, I believe it's Taiwan. And then we have the People's Republic of China, which is Mao Zedong's faction. They would rule the current China. Okay, and then we have the League of Nations. Okay. So in the British Commonwealth of Nations, we can see that there are mercenary Dutch riflemen, mercenaries. They might have been in the previous version too. And they have Australian riflemen and Indian volunteer assault infantry. As for new units, they have the new tortoise artillery gun, mobile artillery gun, and then we have the Crusader 55 in SP. I believe the Sexton is old, the 8025 PDR is old, and I forgot to close down Facebook, too bad. And we have the FV 3805 or FV 3805 is a SPG variant of the all-known Centurion medium tank. Okay, so I believe these are new, these three artillery pieces, and then they have some new tank. They have the Centurion MK7, so I believe this tank is not a World War II tank. Centurion was the primary British tank, main army battle tank of the post-Second World War period. But the game, the campaign, is taking place between 1942 and 1954. So you are in 1954 when the campaign ends, meaning it will go beyond the Second World War, change history. Okay, so that's why there are some tanks and stuff in certain factions that are from the 50s and not just from World War II. So this new tank, the Centurion MK7, is a heavy tank, and it's the tank they used during the 50s, during the Cold War, mostly. And then they had the old Matilda tank. So that's their early World War II tank. And then they have a new one, a Cromwell tank, which is a medium tank. Cromwell tank was one of the series of cruiser tanks fielded by Britain in the Second World War. So it's like a medium tank for the British. It was fielded during World War II. I checked it in battle, and it has a pretty long gun. So it might be better than the Panzer IVs in terms of attack. It has weaker defense or something, I'm not sure. And then we have another tank, the Churchill. It's old. And it's a heavy tank from World War II. So they've gotten a futuristic 50s tank, and they've gotten a medium tank in between the Churchill and the Matilda, and the three new artillery pieces. Of course, there were new projectiles too, to tanks and other stuff, and artillery, of course. Okay, the India faction, I don't think they have gotten anything new, actually. Unless the bishop is new, I'm not sure. The United States of America, they also have access to mercenary Dutch riflemen. And old stuff. You can see here, all of these are old stuff. And Ivan Cunningham, M4 Sherman. T-29, heavy tank T-29 is an American developmental tank, started in March 1944. Yeah, this is old. But they have one new tank here. The M-46 Patton was an American medium tank designed to replace the M-26 Pershing and the M-4 Sherman. So this is a new tank, a medium tank, and probably from the period after World War II, so in the 50s probably. They were used. Okay, that's why they have the name Patton, to remember Patton, because he died, I believe, in the final years of the war, in like 1945 or something. Okay, M7 Priest, M5 Howitzer, I think they are old. They should have one or so new, maybe the T95 here is new, maybe. And one of the others, but at least one of them are new, one of these three. Okay. We have the French Republic. They have now a Spitfire plane, and not just the V-team like before, so they have a British plane too, with a unique French texture. Then they have the all-renowned FT-101 tank, the Sommer S-35 tank, and it's a 30s tank, built in 1936. Then they have the better tank, the RL-45, it was in the previous version. A developmental tank started development in the final years of World War II. In late World War II, before the end actually. But they have a new tank here, the AMX-13 is a French light tank produced from 1952 to 1987. It was in use all the way up until 1987, and it's a medium, it's a light tank actually. But the later one, a more advanced one. Okay. So it's a light tank, just like the Renault, but it has much better technology. Okay, and then they have the Dutch mercenaries, of course. But yeah, I believe the AMX 13 is their new unit. The League of Nations, I think, do not have anything new. And the People's Republic of China, which is the communist part of China. They do have the NC-31 tank, a modification of the Renault FT French tank. They have the M5A1 Stuart, a light tank from the United States that were borrowed to the Chinese. They have the Soviet ES-2 tanks. Okay. The Soviet Union has the ES-3 instead, so they are like older versions that are exported to China during the 50s or late 40s. Then we have the VC-111-14, prototype of a heavy tank developed in China, so it's a prototype. Okay, they have no new unit, I think they have only old new units. As for the Chinese Republic, which is Taiwan, or the nationalist China, they have the same old units as before, nothing new. And then we have the Soviet Union, they have the new rocket trucks, the Katyusha trucks, and they have a completely new projectile that is much superior to the old one. And they have some new artillery, I believe. S-51, I think, is new. Or the SU-5. I'm not sure. One of them is new, I think. And they have the ES-3, it's old. T-35-85. T-34. MS-1. I think they are old. Still do not have any bomber planes, which is a shame, because it would have helped with balance in the campaign if they had had one bomber and one fighter instead of two fighters. Okay. Now let's see the rest of the facts. We can check the Spanish state, Turkey, Japanese Empire, French state Vichy, the Third Reich, Bulgaria, Thailand, and Italy, the Italian Empire. So Spanish state have nothing new. Turkey has nothing new. Japanese Empire, Renault Utsu, which is also a modified Renault, and then Shia is a medium tank, and the Uni is a heavy tank. I believe all of them are old. They have Sierra and Achival, they are old. Yeah, the Japanese have no new units, I think. the French state Vichy. Unlike the other French, the Allied French, they do not have any Spitfires from the British, of course. They have the AMX-13 tanks, they have one new tank. Okay, then we have the Thailand, they have nothing new, I see. And we have Bulgaria. They do not have anything new. Okay, and then we have Italy, the Italian Empire. They have the unique ME-110. Between engine, German heavy fighter. And some Messerschmitts, but they are all. They have the Fight 3000 light tank, the MP2640 medium tanks, the Progetto M35. Progetto M35 heavy tanks. But I believe they have no new units. Okay, let's check the Third Reich. So they have some new units. They have no new infantry or planes, but they do have new artillery and tanks. So we can start with artillery. In the past they had the Stokes Mortars, the PAC-40s, the Vesp mobile artillery, the Hummel mobile artillery, and now they have the Panzerjäger Tiger P Ferdinand. So one new artillery piece here. Then they have the GV Tiger too, it's an old one. So they have one new artillery piece, the Ferdinand. And then they have some new tanks. In the past they had the Panzer 1 light tank, the Panzer 4 medium tank, the Tiger 1 heavy tank, and the Tiger 2 heavy tank, and the Maus. Actually they didn't have anything new. It was wrong. Okay, so the Germans have only one new unit. Okay, they have new projectiles for certain tanks. Okay. Let's see, we have some factions remaining. We have Finland, we have Hungary, we have Romania, we have Portugal, we have the neutrals, which is the rebels, and I think that's it. We will check those now. So Finland, can't see that they have anything new here. They have the old units, but they have some really cool units like the ski troops. Okay, then we have the Hungary faction. They have unique tanks, Toldi tanks and Turan tanks. They have no new units in this update. We have Romania, no new units. Portugal, I don't think they have any new units there either. Neutrals, Hermelins, they lack a unit card. Okay, but no new units. So then we have the Bulgaria faction, and I think they have the old units too. Yeah, so there are not that many new units, but some of them. And we had the new cities of Berlin and Paris. But also in the campaign, we have all of the French cities completed and all the German cities completed. And we have the town, large town and city, I believe, of the Italian cities completed as well. And I believe one town or something of one African town is finished as well. I'm not sure about Japan, but there might be a town or something finished. I'm not sure. Check the Warfront campaign and the 1942 campaigns, maybe. We will check the Warfront campaign. So we have the Europe campaign, the nice heater here. You can see the Soviet troops here. Europe campaign, they are preparing to invade Finland and the German Reich. Okay, the European Front, 1939. So this campaign starts in 1939, while the other one starts in 1942. This one is only set in Europe, while the other one is the entire world. Okay, selecting this campaign will give you the control of a faction before World War II starts. So unlike the other campaign, World War II hasn't started yet. So there are a lot of rebel areas on the map. in the World War II main campaign, Germany has already conquered most of the smaller nations and France. But in he has conquered all, Hitler has conquered all the small nations and France already, and is about to fight Soviets near Stalingrad. But in this version, I believe they haven't even started a war yet. Because we have a, I believe, a faction limit of 12 factions, we couldn't add any more factions to the campaign, because it's still the same game. So there are no new factions. Instead, all the unconquered areas are rebel held. And I believe Dagovax also did make some of the German areas rebel in Germany, and some of the other areas for other factions rebel as well, because he thought the game wasn't fun when they started with all their areas. The smaller factions wouldn't have a chance. So he decided to add more rebel areas than historically, than it would have been historically accurate. I believe historically Germany would hold all their areas plus Austria and Czechoslovakia, but in this campaign they are not holding all their areas because of balance reasons, I believe. Starting in 1939, you can do whatever you want as you don't have allies or enemies yet. Yeah, he hasn't added any allies or enemies either. I believe he should make Britain and France allied if he hasn't done that, because they were allied. But besides them, I don't think there were any allies. I mean, Mussolini and Japan. I don't remember exactly when they signed the Axis Pact. Maybe they did that in 1938 or something, I'm not sure. But Italy didn't join the war until 1940, so even if they signed the pact a lot earlier. And Japan is far away, they aren't in Europe, so okay. So the Spanish state should be neutral. French Republic and the British Commonwealth of Nations should be allied already in this campaign, and Turkey neutral, USSR neutral, the Italian Empire. They probably had the Axis Pact signed with Germany, but they wouldn't join the war until 1940, so neutral is good. Then Bulgaria and Hungary, I'm not sure. I believe they were forced into joining the German alliance in 1940, so they should probably be neutral. Finland in 1939 were alone, they fought the Soviets alone, so okay. Romania, same story as with Hungary and Bulgaria, they haven't yet joined the Germans. And the Portugal, I believe they were friendly to the British, but not allied. Okay, so the only alliances in this campaign should be French Republic and the British Commonwealth of Nations. Of course, they were allied with Poland too, but they are not a faction. Maybe the Soviet Union and the the Soviet Union and the German Reich, the Third Reich, they might have the non-aggression pact by this time, but they didn't have an alliance, they had a non-aggression pact, and I don't believe in the realms of war you can have a non-aggression agreement. So okay, we can check the campaign. You see that the difficulty varies depending on what faction you start the game as. So now we have the Spanish state selected. I believe the French would be interesting to look at in this campaign, because they start with all France. In the other campaign they start in Africa, and France has already fallen. But in the 1939 campaign they are holding France itself. So yeah, we will start it with France. There were no intervideo for the French Republic. Hmm. powerful ideology, fascism, government in exile, French state Vichy. This faction lost its capital and is now on the move with its latest army to find another settlement to capture. Okay. So you can see that Paris has a unique custom strat model. In the other campaign, it doesn't have it. I believe the main campaign has a German city model. Maybe that should be corrected, because it would be cool to have the French strat model in both campaigns, but anyway, it's not very important, and if it's not playable, then it doesn't really matter. I will try out the campaign later. So, to your FOV... Oh, I clicked the wrong button. Toggle FOV or toggle FOV to make the entire map visible. So you can see here we are controlling 8 regions as the French Republic. We have won 0 battles, we have lost 0 battles, victory condition, survivor, hold 15 provinces and destroy or outlast the following faction or factions, the Third Reich, the Italian Empires. We need to destroy or outlast them. That means when they are defeated, no matter which faction is killing them off, we will win if we are holding 15 regions. Okay, diplomacy, we are not allied to anyone. That's probably an unfinished part, because Britain and France did have an alliance in 1939. That's why they had an alliance with each other and with Poland. That's why when Germany attacked Poland, they would come to the aid of Poland. So, but that's the only alliance that would make sense. The Italian Empire was allied on paper, but wouldn't join the war, as I said. So they shouldn't be allied in 1939. But the French and the British, they should, in my opinion, be allied. Okay, as you can see, Berlin has a new strat model too. The Berlin city, it looks like the city, but with some extra detail in the middle. You can see that the map itself is different. It's only in Europe now, with more regions in Europe and more detail. So Degovax made an entire new map for the European smaller campaign. So he had planned to make a European campaign, an Asian campaign, a Southeast Asian campaign actually, and I believe an African campaign and the main campaign. But in the end, in this version for Rome Total War and Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion, we only got 2 versions. And in this version, this one is new. It's never been in a release before. So the question is how playable they are. Can they be played until the end, or will they crash at a certain point and then continue to crash when you start it up? I know that CTD is to be expected, but as long as we can start it up and continue, it's fine. To have a CTD in battle or before and after battles is common with mods, but if it happens every time at the same turn, that would make the campaign unplayable. So that's what I want to find out, if it still has that issue or not. This campaign, I hope, will not have it, because it's new and fresh. So chances are that it's stable too. The World War II main campaign, on the other hand, might be unstable. It would be unfortunate if that's the case. So the French have areas in Africa. We are holding some areas here. Hold Marius in the Middle East too. We hold Aleppo in the Middle East and the bordering Britain. I don't like that Britain is not allied, because this would mean that Britain and France will immediately declare war on each other in this campaign. Actually, I might probably modify that myself before starting a campaign, because I don't want the British and the French to fight each other. I will modify the file and ally the British with the French. But otherwise, I think they can be sandboxed in this version. I mean, the Italians and the Germans, they could as well have started war against each other. Mussolini only joined with Hitler in the war, and he saw that Hitler won the war in France. He saw that the German army steamrolled France in 3 months or something. And after that he was convinced to join in and grab some stuff from France. Okay, so in 1939, before the war had started, things could have taken a different route. So Mussolini had good relations with Britain, with the United States, and with some others before the war. He was in power since the early 20s, so he had some good relations. He even visited the United States at one point, if I'm not wrong, and could speak pretty good English. So chances are that Mussolini could have joined allies as well if things had taken a different route. Okay. So we have Britain, now with more regions in mainland Britain, and we have Spanish state, we have Portugal, we have France or the French Republic, we have the Italian Empire, we have the Third Reich or the German Reich, we have the smaller factions here, we have Hungary and Romania, and we have Bulgaria as well, and then we have the Soviet Union. We have Turkey, and we have the British Commonwealth of Nations down here as well. So that's the factions. So this map is, in my opinion, much more beautiful. It's smaller, but it has more beautiful terrain, more impressive mountains, bigger, taller, etc. More detail, but smaller in size. However, the other campaign is impressive in its sheer size. That it has the entire world. But it's less impressive in terms of how things look aesthetically on the map. It is more flat. Okay. It will be interesting to fight battles in the Italian cities and the French cities in this version. I have already played in all the German cities with the exception of Berlin itself. So of course Berlin in this version would be more interesting, and Paris would be really interesting. In custom battle, Paris used to crash after a few seconds. After a few seconds after starting the battle. Okay. But I won't play the campaign now. I want to change that alliance with Britain first. I want Britain and France to be allied. So they won't fight each other in the Middle East and in Africa. Also, I believe Turkey was neutral. But they had very good relations with the British. They sent planes to pilots to Britain that were trained in Britain, and they actually did in some cases partake in bombings over Berlin during their training. Okay, so Turkey could also be allied to the British and French, but they could just as well be neutral. Italians, just for to keep it in later events, could of course be allied to Germany, but the only one that should be allied is the French and the British. Okay, thanks for watching this. Maybe we should check the other campaign too. Single play 1942 campaign. Here we have some more factions, of course. It's the other campaign. Let's see here. Let's start it with Germany. They have a new UI. So we have toggle FOV or toggle FAV on already. You can see the entire map. So this map is very similar to the version I played. And you can see the new UI, the new German UI here. I don't know how many factions have gotten a new UI, but Germany was one of them. It's pretty cool, the UI. Still have some Rome portraits here and there. The user interface is now pretty cool. Okay. See some BMW motorcycles here and some boats there. I suggest that he should have added tanks here instead of BMW motorcycles. The Tiger 2 would have been better, I think. Anyway. New building portraits. Perhaps some of them were in the version that I played. We have Berlin added here. Berlin and they with their own unique custom strat model. France has this model, but it's probably France in battle, hopefully. Still have the ships. I believe they have new portraits actually. I don't remember them looking like this. The ego access replaced the portraits, or is the new UI making me think that? I'm not sure. Okay. There's some ships. Finland had already taken Petrozavodsk at the start of the campaign. So when I played as Germans, I removed the script that forced all these Soviet troops to just stand there as a wall. They were originally intended to be a wall here, so when you as the player playing Germany invades the east, you will have to go through all of these just like in history. But I removed that script so that they could move, and that led to all of these armies steamrolling Germany. Of course I could hold them back for quite a while, but in the end it became too much with all these armies and armies that they recruit, and Germany in the end couldn't hold them back despite sending all their troops from Africa, Greece and Finland, from Norway and Denmark to aid, and we had just one front against Soviet, but we still couldn't hold them back in the end, and they in the end defeated us. And in the final days of the Reich, the Spanish state, which was a neutral faction, declared war on us and took our French territories too, and other areas in Europe that weren't German. Okay. So, you can see that the campaign looks very much the same as in the version that I played. Now with all the new settlements, new units, new projectiles, new animations. Planes are using the new animation, of course. I don't know if I would prefer playing with it or not. It's probably more easy to control the planes if you play manually. It's less cool, in my opinion, to watch the battles if the AI is controlling them. Looked better when they moved around in a circle. Okay. So, I'm sure the Ego X has done some changes on the map to improve it. It's hard to know exactly where changes have been made. Okay. So I don't know how stable this is. I suspect it won't be stable. And that we will probably crash at the same time. At a certain point. After every restart. Okay, so I'm sorry, but I don't think I will be able to play a campaign. I will try it. I will try without recording first. And if it works, then I will start a campaign and record. But they don't want to record and all that stuff, and then just find out that, oh, at after 40 turns, it will sit at the same place all the time. Then it's better to not play and record. I mean, if I don't record, I don't have to speak, and if I don't have to speak, it's less troublesome and less of a loss if it's impossible to continue it. Okay, so I want to try it out first and see if it's stable. If it's stable, we'll play it and record. If it's not stable, we won't. And we'll probably try to port some stuff to the other version and play another campaign there instead. But if the European campaign is stable and this one isn't, then we'll play the European campaign. Even though it sucks we can't play the World War II campaign. Because in the end, it would be fun to play a faction here and conquer the whole world. Like I wanted to do with Germany. They had personally modified it to be more close to history, and Soviet Union was far too strong. So I never got to conquer any areas outside of Europe because I was on the defensive and lost the war. Okay, so thanks for watching and see ya. Hello, Mr. Nylund here. So I forgot one thing. We can check civilian. We can check cities in the civilian view, by the way. And we can check Berlin. We'll do that. Just need to find out what button I need to check. Okay, view settlement on the battle map. This video is still part of the preview, the new 2.0 version of Total War 1942 for Rome Total War and Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. So this is Berlin, the capital. You will have soldiers walking around. Now I of course want to check other cities too, like the... I don't agree with Daigwak's decision to remove the guns from the civilian soldiers moving around. I think it looked much better when they carry their rifles and such in this view. If he's gonna use civilians, it's better to make unique models for them that are civilians. Because in reality, if you have soldiers walking around like this, they would carry their guns. It would be soldiers patrolling with their guns in their hands, like in the previous version of the mod. I believe removing the guns made it look worse, in my opinion, because if you look on documentaries from World War II, you can see that the German soldiers, they did walk around on the streets, and they were armed when they walked around on the streets. They would march on the streets. You would see both civilians and soldiers on the streets. And the Germans always, the soldiers always had their rifles in their hands. So without rifles, it doesn't look right for a soldier, you know. Then it's better to replace them with civilians. Because this unit here, it looks like it's supposed to be holding a gun. And the ones that look walk like this, they look better, but still would be better if they had their guns, in my opinion. Okay. But anyway, let's check this actual city. So here we have the Reichstag. So we've seen it in other videos before the city was finished. Have some generic buildings. We have the big concern. It's built at the start of the campaign. You can see some mechanized trucks or cars. Have some officers' field wagons. or jeeps, some anti-aircraft guns. Yeah, those are troop transports. I believe we have the Brandenburg Gate here. Right. So from this side we have the Brandenburg Gate. Maybe this wall is a little weirdly placed. We have the road here and then the wall is there. It will be kind of a collision there. But maybe it can't be helped. They will have to move like this. Okay, then we have these generic buildings. We saw them when I fought the Battle of Berlin in my German campaign. They were also in the large city settlement, so they are used in both. But of course this settlement, which is supposed to be Berlin itself, so I used the large city as a placeholder in the previous version. But this version is the actual this is the actual Berlin settlement, so of course it's more grand in size and more detailed. Here we have the army headquarters. So it's surrounded by bunkers, the Siegfried Wall. We have some German imperial flags. Here we have the heavy tank factory. Okay. Can't zoom out more than this. So we'll have to look around to find buildings. Here we have another one. We have the aerodrome. Here we can see some Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, the aircraft guns. Of course they are used for look, can't really move. More of the Messerschmitts there too. Okay, the aerodrome. So that's the airfield, and then the plaza here. German imperial flags lining the road, some bridges here. Still cool with the troops moving, but yeah, it looked better with the troops holding their guns. Because when you take over a city, they will also move around like this, and it looks more like an occupation if they hold their weapons. I don't think soldiers would ever leave their guns behind, or rifles. Okay, and then might be something else we have missed. Here we have a church, Catholic church, but it's probably a vanilla one. It enabled me to look from a little higher above the ground, thanks to this tower here. So this is the church, probably vanilla. Some generic houses. Brandenburg Gate over there. Reichstag over there. Okay. Headquarters, we had already seen that, I think. Another church here, Catholic church. Okay, and then we have the bunker. It's pretty cool, big, can even place troops inside. The camera can't be inside, but the troops can. this a defensive structure, then move in here and shoot from inside of it. Yeah, I like that the troops are moving around. It's better to have troops like this than to have civilians from Road to War. But re-add the guns and rifles, it would be better. Okay, in Lord of the Rings to the War, I believe the Isengard troops that are moving around have weapons, but I'm not sure, maybe I'm wrong. But I think they still held their shields and swords, and it looked better, because then you feel like, let's say this is Paris, and you have taken it. Then when you look at the city in the civilian view, then you feel like a conqueror, seeing your troops move around in the streets, and the buildings are still destroyed and such, the walls are still broken or damaged. Then you feel like a conqueror when you see the troops moving around on the streets with their gun, with their swords and shields, I mean. And the same could be true for this mod. Of course, this will be more like we take a break from the fighting, but... Ah. They need rifles. Okay, but Berlin is very cool. Cool city. Oh, we could move up even further if we move like this. Now we can see the Reichstag building from far above. So it looks like this. So there is no Reich Chancellery, because Dagovax got the models from, I believe, the Battlefield game, or the World of Tanks game, I'm not sure, and he couldn't find any model of the Reich Chancellery, so the Reichstag was in use during the Weimar Republic, which was the democratic German state that existed from the end of World War I and until Hitler took over. So the Reichstag was burnt down by Hitler and the Nazis in 1933, I think, after which they blamed the communists and arrested them, and then it was rebuilt to some extent, but it wasn't the seat of power of Hitler's Germany. The seat of power of Hitler's Germany, as far as I know, was the Reich Chancellery, beneath which the bunker was located. But there is no model for it, so it's not in the game. But the Reichstag is still seen as a very important building, and there are still, you know, pictures of the Soviet troops coming here and moving up these stairs and past these buildings here. There are also many videos with Hitler and Nazis when they stand on these steps and such. So the Reichstag building is still important and is the center of the capital in this mod or game. But in real life, it would have been the Reich Chancellor. Okay, and then the Brandenburg Gate is, of course, the other important location of Berlin that is in this mod. Can't really have Berlin without the Brandenburg Gate, the entrance of the city. So we have two locations, Brandenburg and the Reichstag. Okay, and in Paris, I believe he even based the map on pictures from the air of the city. And they have the Eiffel Tower and everything. Okay, now we have seen Berlin, let's return to the map. Okay, we're back on the map. And I believe I can't check any more cities. We are not holding any Italian cities. Maybe we can check Paris. We are holding it. We'll see if it's the capital. We'll do that too. see if it's actually Paris. Nope. So Paris in the main World War II campaign is not Paris, it's just a generic German city, I believe. Let's see. That's maybe something they should look into. So in the European minor campaign we have Paris on the map and in battle with a unique custom city, and it's also in custom battle, but on in the main World War II campaign it's still a German city. Okay, so then we know we can't check the French cities in this campaign. So in essence I believe we need to change the files of the French cities so they will spawn French buildings instead of the German ones. It's done in the Discostrat file. I think I could do that. In Medieval 2 I can for sure. Room to the War is slightly different, but if I'm gonna play this campaign and it's stable, then yeah, I will probably try to enable the French custom cities here. Because even if Germany is holding France, the cities should still be French and not German. The main campaign still needs French cities on the map and in battle. Especially on in battle, I mean. I believe Degwex hasn't completed the strat models. He did complete Paris, strat model of Paris, but not the other French strat models. Okay. For Italy, I believe they have 3 cities at least, but I don't know if they are in this campaign. They probably are. Okay, but at least Berlin is in the campaign. Okay, I will try to continue and see if this game will crash in a few turns or not, but I won't record. Okay, so see ya. Hello, Mr. Nyland here. So we're playing Total War 1942, a mod for Room to the War and Room to the War Barbarian Invasion. So it's version 2.0 that released 2 days ago, and I've just installed a patch for it. So the game lagged slightly when I played it on Steam. I'm playing using the CD now. I believe the CD doesn't lag as much because the graphics are slightly worse. I believe the terrain of the battlefields are slightly more beautiful in the Steam version. So the game lags less on the CD. Because the terrain isn't as beautiful.
Our men okay. Are fleeing the battle. Rally them.
So that's why I prefer playing the CD version. So we are letting the AI fight AI. We have 3 great armies versus 3 great armies. We have 2 French armies and 1 British army facing off against 3 German armies. And you're playing on the battlefield of Normandy, and in this version the fighter planes are easier to micromanage because they are not flying around in a circle anymore. Instead they are standing still when they stop moving. I prefer the older animation for fighters, but I think this is better for bombers. Of course it's all up to Degwex Rianus, the creator of the mod, how he wants it. But if I'm gonna play a campaign, I'll probably try to re-implement the other animation for the fighter planes. I find it more fun to see the battles between the planes when it has the old animation compared to when they will stand in the air like this. However, I must say I'm impressed with the planes having a moving propeller. As you can see, the propeller is moving for all the planes now. They also are kind of I don't remember the word, but they are levitating in the air when they stand still, so it doesn't look as bad as if they were just standing still without moving, but you can see that it's kind of needs to be standing still for us to be able to see it. Yeah, they are kind of moving slightly up and down. Now the trees are in the way, but it's perfect for this battlefield, Normandy. That's probably the forest is the Ardennes forest, so it's correct. Of course it's annoying when you want to see the units on the ground. They have a lot of trees in the way and such. Check the balance of power. 32% allies killed and 12% enemies killed. Our side is the allied side. French and the British. Okay, enemy side is only consisting of German troops. They have early units, so no units that weren't around in 1939-1940. Okay, so no 1942 units, 1943 units or later units. Okay, so I think this version has much more cool new projectiles, bigger tanks and such. But yeah, the fighter planes were more fun and they moved around. I guess Regwex did that because he wants it to be easier for the player to control. So I can see why he did it. But the battles do not look as good when they stand still. Okay, but otherwise I think this update is impressive. It's added a lot of new units for many factions. Yes, added new projectiles for many factions, as we can see. These are all new, these projectiles. And yes, added an entire new campaign, a European custom campaign. Yes, added a new custom settlements. Campaign and a custom battle, such as Berlin, Paris, etc. So I played the version before the VIP from January 2020, where I played an entire German campaign that I lost in the end after 18 episodes. And each episode was between like 2 hours to between 1 hour and 40 minutes to maybe 3 hours or something long. Okay, unfortunately this video we didn't see much because of the trees. So Vegoxian is moving and porting the mod to Rooted Lore Remaster or to Lore Room Remastered. But that will take a while for him to do. We need to support the entire mod, so. So the mod will show up in the remaster as well, and will he has scrapped the work on this version. This is the final release on the old Road to War game engine. The completed version will be for the remaster. 2.0 version is the last version that will be released on the old original Road to War game. Oh, here we have some German U-88 heavy bombers have been taken out of twin engine fighters, actually. And the animations of the tanks are better now too. At least it looks better because they are bigger and such. We have some Renault FT. French tanks facing off against the German Panzer IV tanks that are clearly much bigger. Superior. Renault FT tanks are World War I tanks. They're outdated. Some anti-aircraft trucks there. So the fighter planes, they look good when they move. But most of the time they stand still when they fire. Yeah, it moves. At least I think it works to have it like this too. Propellers are cool. So we are losing the battle. 2% allies killed and 4% of the enemy general fallen. Germans had an advantage in the early war. Britain and France were not really ready for war at the beginning. They had outdated tanks and such. World War I inspired. Of course, France had France had some tanks and other stuff that were just as good as Germany's, if not better. But their commanders were more competent than the German ones, okay, and their politicians especially, and as for the British, they didn't have that good stuff in the beginning of the war. They had very bad tanks. For example, in this battle, we only had the Matilda tank because the other tanks of their army were arriving in the middle of the war or late war, like 1941 or 2 or later. Yeah, the game didn't lag, in my opinion, in this battle. I don't think I experienced any lag. I played the same battle on the same battlefield in the Steam version, and it lagged because on Steam the terrain were much more beautiful and enhanced, which caused lag on huge size, and we had three armies versus three armies. The battle is over. The Allies lost. Okay, clear defeat. See that the first French army killed 541, that's very good, under Captain Francois Charles Joseph. Then we had Captain Augustine, who killed only 92, that wasn't good. He had the same army and managed to kill only 92. Then we had Captain James of the British army, leading the British army, and he killed 222. That's okay, but it wasn't very good. But they had kind of all sucky troops. They had all their infantry, they had all their planes, but they had sucky artillery and sucky tanks. They didn't have any of their better ones because they arrived later in the war. Okay, and the Germans, all their armies killed a lot of troops. The first army under Captain Jorg killed 689 men, and Captain Werner killed 514, and Captain Wilhelm killed 442. So the German armies were all the same, the French armies were all the same, with the exception of this one. I retreated it immediately, it was only an officer's car. So my army retreated immediately. Okay, and yeah, they killed different numbers, even though they had the same unit types. Okay, and the British army were the worst one. Of course, there were one French army that did worse than the British. Okay, but the one of the French armies did almost as good as the... It did better than two of the German armies. Slightly worse than the best German army. Okay. So battle statistics screen. Here we can see some statistics. Okay, thanks for watching. See ya.